Chopped liver may be what I should be feeling right now after my dreams of entering the Kitchen Musicals slip away from my grasp. But as long as I can cook a mean pork chop, I know I can find my way to someone who can make my dreams come true. Hey, there's next season, right? Anyway, now I'm gonna put on a really great performance, pork chops with butcher's butter. So we're gonna start by making the butcher's butter. I'm gonna need a bowl. Okay, so this is a really simple butter. First, we have room temperature butter, of course. It's always easier to work with. Let's just scrape that off. And then to this, we're gonna add a little bit of Dijon mustard. So we're rocking a little bit of the French theme. So I'm gonna add in about a heaping teaspoon. This is about 1 tablespoon if you're trying to be exact, but you don't have to be. So I'm adding in some sweet pickle relish. Now I like using sweet because I like the balance between the sweetness here and the zestiness of the mustard. So I'm gonna add in a couple of tablespoons. You can just eyeball it. And then a little bit of cayenne pepper for heat. So you can add as much as you like, a little bit more, and then some salt and pepper. Just a little bit of salt. The mustard is very flavorful. And a little bit of black pepper. Okay, so we're just gonna mix this together. Now there's really no such thing as a butcher's butter. I actually named that myself. And the inspiration behind that is charcutier sauce or butcher's sauce. And it's basically your brown sauce, and then you add in some pickles and then some mustard. That's why I'm using the Dijon mustard and the pickle relish. And what's gonna happen is it's gonna have really great zestiness, a little bit of sweetness, a little bit of spiciness, and it's gonna go great with our savory pork chops. Okay, so our butter is just about ready. I'm gonna set this aside. And then let's take care of the pork chops. So we're gonna season with some salt and pepper. Okay, a little bit of black pepper. And then we're gonna need 2 more things for extra flavor. So I've got here some dried sage and some paprika. So paprika is a sweet pepper powder. And it's also gonna give us a really nice color. And then some dried sage. I love sage with pork, it makes it really savory. So I'm gonna heat up my pan. And then we're gonna need a little bit of olive oil. So just leave them be for about 1.5 minutes, and then we'll flip them over. Okay, so I'm gonna let them finish cooking in the oven. 5 minutes at 200 degrees Celsius.
Dreaming of something steaming. Chops baking in the oven. See, I told you, Manuel can make a song out of anything. Pork chops, no problem for Manuel. I'll make a song.
Ah, these pork chops look really great. Okay, so I'm gonna let these guys rest first, and I'm gonna finish the dish with a little bit of veggie topping. Really, really simple. Just a little bit of olive oil. So I've got here some tomatoes and zucchini. So first, a little bit of zucchini right into our hot oil. And then a little bit of tomato as well. And you can change this up if you'd like. You can add in some black olives, for example. Squash is a good idea too. Now we're gonna season with some salt and pepper. Okay, so let's just mix this up. Okay, so you just wanna make sure that your veggies are nice and caramelized. Okay, so these are actually good. I want them to stay crunchy. So I'm gonna shut the heat off. Nice. Okay, so I'm just gonna set these aside, and actually everything is done. So we're just gonna assemble the dish. First, a little bit of our pork chops, and then the vegetable topping, and then right on top is our butcher's butter. It's gonna be a feast. Look at that. That is the perfect bite. I've got the zucchini, the tomato, the butter, the pork. All that's left is eating it. Mm. That is just awesome. The pork is juicy and then it's really savory. You've got that nice crunch of the veggies and then that butter. Oh, that butter. It brings great balance because it's a little bit sweet, a little bit sour, and then a little bit spicy. A great balance of flavor on a pork dish, that's music to my ears.